Hi, I'm Marlo Budiman, Chief Executive Officer and President Director of Linknet. Financial results in the first quarter of 2021 have been exceptionally strong and are a continuation of the success we had in 4Q 2020. Linknet booked a revenue of 1.07 trillion rupiah in the first quarter 2021, growing 11.4% year on year. The company booked EBITDA of 624 billion in the first quarter 2021, growing 21.1% year on year. Our EBITDA margin expanded to 58.4% in the first quarter 2021, growing 470 basis points compared with the first quarter 2020. Linknet booked net income of 249 billion rupiah in 1Q 2021, growing 26% year on year. Net profit margin expanded to 23.3% in the first quarter 2021, growing 270 basis points as compared with the first quarter 2020. Our strong financial results are due to the continued investment we have made in our business as well as continued a heightened demand for broadband and related services. The COVID-19 pandemic accelerated changes in consumer behavior, and many of these behavioral changes, such as increased demand in broadband, internet, and related services, are all in likelihood permanent changes and are here to stay. We continue to successfully migrate our network, and as at the end of May, we have now completed approximately one-third of the entire project. Each month from January to April in 2021 saw our team migrate more poles than the previous months as we continue to increase our capacity. Even in May, with the seasonal slowdown due to the Lebaran holidays, we have accomplished the migration of more than 9,000 poles. We are on track to complete our migration project by the middle of 2022. Through growing operational efficiency, the team has performed its work well under our initial budget of 3 trillion rupiah. We are revising down our migration capex guidance to a total budget of 2.5 trillion rupiah, a 500 billion rupiah decrease from our original budget. The migration team continues to drive operational efficiencies, and we will continue to update the market on our continued success. In the lifetime of our company, the migration project is only for a short duration, and it will soon be finished. Upon completion, we will dedicate our now substantial operational capacity to begin aggressively expanding our network at far higher rates than we have done in the past. As a management team, our core focus is growing long-term earnings growth. We will achieve this through the continued expansion of our network and rapidly growing our subscriber base. We will also continue to productively engage with our customers to share a broader range of higher value products and services so they can regularly upgrade to throughout their customer lifecycle. I am proud of the work that my management team and their staff have done in the first quarter of 2021. We have started 2021 with strong results, and I look forward to updating you on our continued success throughout the year. I wish you and your family safety and the best of health. Thank you.
Hi, I'm Edward Sanusi, Chief Technology Officer and Head of Product at PT Linknet. Our network has continued to be resilient and provides high-quality internet connections even in times of significant demand, especially during the Lebaran holiday period. In the travel restriction during the holidays, family consume large amount of data to have online gathering. We were well prepared, and our network has significant capacity, which ensured that we could easily withstand the spike in data and provide all our users with stable and consistent high-speed internet connection. As families are spending more time at home with each other, it's crucial that we continue to innovate our product suite to provide our customer with a market-leading entertainment experience. In the first quarter of 2021, we launched a product called First Plus, which integrates of our OTT partners in one package. First Plus provides our customers with CatchPlay, View, GoPlay, and HBO Go in one consolidated package. These OTT services, in addition to our linear channels, provide our customers with an extensive range of both Western, Asia, and local Indonesian on-demand content. We also added a product called First Google Cloud. This is a new value-added services which we introduced to cater the increasing customer demand for storing digital assets, such as family photos and videos. This product is based on Google Cloud solution and we expect demand for this since we believe cloud-based will continue to grow. We will continue to explore our value-added services, including cloud offerings in addition to providing content and high-speed internet to ensure we have the most comprehensive product offering in Indonesia. As our business continue to expand, it's essential that we have optimal operational efficiency so that we can effectively manage our costs and support revenue growth. In this digital transformation journey, we implemented SAP in back office to drive efficiencies in finance and operation, and at the same time provide us with flexibility and agility to go to the market. Our enterprise business continues to grow its contribution to our overall revenue and earnings. To support their continued growth and increase the efficiency, we have rolled out Salesforce solution for our enterprise sales team. We will continue to invest in digital transformations to drive effectivity and revenue growth. I am very pleased with the work of Linknet's technology team who have ensured that our customers have consistent and stable high-speed internet connection throughout the COVID pandemic. Our product team has continued to innovate to ensure that our customers have a market-leading entertainment experience. I'm very proud of what the teams have done to enhance the customer satisfaction at such a crucial time, as well as their contribution to driving shareholder value. I wish all of our customers and investors safety and good health.
Hi, I'm Santiwati Basuki, Linknet Chief Marketing Officer. We continue to invest in our digital self-service capabilities to increase customer convenience and to reduce our costs. We now provide the option for customers to upgrade their package or add various value-added services via our self-care application, My First Media App. Customers are becoming more comfortable with digital self-service application and e-wallet payment options, and we will continue to invest and grow our digital sales channels. From digital advertisement side, we are optimizing our digital ads placement profiling and targeting to increase leads conversion. We have been conducting joint promotion programs with some of Indonesia's major e-commerce platforms, including Tokopedia and Shopee. We will extend the promotion with other e-commerce partners in the second quarter. In 2021 and the future years, we will proactively invest in the growth of our digital capabilities so that a larger portion of our customers come onto our platform, as well as upgrade their services through our self-service applications rather than through direct contact with our sales force. As more customers open and upgrade accounts through our digital channels, this will put downward pressure on our operational expenses through decreased costs of new subscriber acquisition. We have continued to be proactive with our offline marketing activities to continue growing our subscriber base. We held 1,100 sales promotion events within our network cities in the first quarter of 2021. These events are highly productive at raising our brand awareness, generating high quality leads, and importantly, increasing the number of new accounts. We ran a product awareness campaign to remind existing as well as prospective customers that Linknet offers truly unlimited download quotas without restricting downloads when certain levels are reached. This is enabled to our strong network management and abundant capacity which we still implement to this day. This differentiates us from various competitors in the market, who due to limitation of their network infrastructure are unable to offer the same to their customers. Through our collective sales marketing activities, we successfully added 20,000 new net subscribers to enjoy our services in the first quarter of 2021, taking our total subscriber base to 859,000 subscribers. It's important that we continue to support the community during the pandemic. Through these difficult times, we have supported both medical workers, teachers, as well as children through their online activities by providing free internet access. In 2021, we have offered our subscribers whose profession as a teacher with 3 months free internet access to help them with their teaching from home duties. We have also set up Wi-Fi hotspots in community areas such as sports and recreation clubs where children can come and access the internet to facilitate learning from home during the pandemic. We are in the same situation together, and our support to Indonesian communities will be continued through our future programs. The Linknet sales and marketing teams have built upon their work in previous quarters to ensure that we started 2021 on a strong footing. I'm incredibly proud of everything we have accomplished in the first quarter to both help our customers in these tough times and to continue driving shareholder value through strong operational results. Thank you to our loyal customers and shareholders. We wish you and your family safety and good health.
Hi everyone, I'm Agung Wiguna, Linknet Enterprise Sales Director. Linknet Enterprise Business has undergone a transformation over the past 3 years. Pre-pandemic enterprise revenue has been an upward trajectory as an absolute number, but also a percentage of the company's overall revenue. We do expect this trend to continue in the future as our enterprise team goes from strength to strength. We have a number of key projects in the pipeline that I expect to be very impactful on the enterprise revenue throughout 2021. We have continued to focus on targeting business within industry which have minimum negative impact from the COVID pandemic. This includes expanding our relationship with business within the financial services and the government sectors. We've also deepened our relationship with our largest clients by revamping our product suite and by proposing long-term solutions that cater the business during this pandemic situation. We have continued to grow our market penetration of industrial estate and business parks through targeted pre-wiring. Pre-wiring is the process of fiberization of building or industrial complex in the anticipation that our sales team will successfully be able to win business from clients within those buildings. Pre-wiring significantly reduces the time that it takes to connect a new customer and also a very worth investment. We will continue to strategically pre-wire to assist with our new client acquisition. As part of our strategy to provide a broader range of services, we've grown our penetration by providing a satellite connectivity services, so-called VSAT. This is a highly useful product for a business who are in rural areas, such as oil and mining companies, or for those who frequently conduct a business offshore, such as a shipping company. We continue to penetrate the satellite services market with Linknet complete satellite solution to customers across Indonesia. We're starting to see signs of a recovery in demand for business-to-business enterprise solution. We are commencing some large project and I expect to see upward pressure on the enterprise revenue. I'm optimistic about the future of the enterprise business in 2021 and years after, significantly growth that we will have in future years. I'm incredibly proud of the work that my team has done to assist our customer during these difficult times. We will continue to work with our customer to ensure that we all fight and get through this pandemic together. I wish you and your family safety and a good health. Thank you.
Hi, I'm Johannes, Linknet Chief Financial Officer. Linknet booked strong financial and operational results in the first quarter 2021. We successfully added 49,000 additional home pass to our network, taking the total network size to over 2.7 million home pass. We added additional 20,000 net subscribers and now have a total of 859,000 residential customers. Average revenue per user was booked at 358,000 rupiah, and we continue to have the market-leading ARPU. Despite booking strong financial growth in the first quarter of 2021, the business continued to effectively manage costs. Revenue in the first quarter increased 11.4% year-on-year. However, cost of sale increased by only 2% in the same period. Operating expenses have decreased by 1.4% year-on-year. With rising revenue driven by continued subscriber growth and maintaining a strong ARPU, our year-on-year EBITDA grew by 21.1% to 624 billion rupiah, and net income grew 26% to 249 billion rupiah. We are pleased to announce the revised guidance for our migration capex, which we have now revised down from 3 trillion rupiah to 2.5 trillion rupiah. This naturally has a positive impact on our cash flow, but also as we continue to beat our budget, it also reduces future depreciation forecast as well. The reduction of 500 billion rupiah will reduce future depreciation by approximately 33 billion rupiah per year over the 15 years accounting life of the assets. Costs for pole rental in the first quarter of 2021 were 39 billion rupiah. The vast majority of this paid to PLN for the use of their electricity poles. By the end of the second quarter 2022, we expect to have completed the migration project and upon completion, will no longer be paying substantial quarterly fees. Upon completion of our migration project, we will also be in a position to gradually pay down debt and thus reduce our interest expense. Looking forward the second half of 2022 and beyond, we expect a lowering cost base but also growing revenue as the business shift to aggressive expansion of its network as well as subscriber acquisition. The future of our business remains bright. While we are heavily focused on our migration project, we continue to plan for the future to ensure that we can drive shareholder value through growing our network and subscriber base as well as continuing to effectively manage our cost base. The migration project is on schedule, under budget, and fully funded. The project will be finished soon, and we are preparing to embark on the next phase of the company's growth. I am excited about our future and look forward to updating you on our continued success. I wish you and your family health and success. Thank you.